Dad? Is it really you? Dad? Is it really you?
Today, I want to do a specialty video. I want to shed some light on Mr. Walter Hill. Walter Hill is the very definition of underrated and underappreciated. He's a Hollywood maverick and a master of what I like to call the two-fisted fairy tale. He's proven himself an indispensable talent time and time again, decade after decade, as a writer, as a producer, and of course, as a director. Many of the projects he's been a part of over the years are movies I count as favorites of their genre. I mean, the guy helped write Alien, for example. And his unwillingness to bend to confused studio ideals and wills that have never really understood him anyway may have caused him a lot of extra hurdles in his long-lasting career. But honestly, the films he's directed speak for themselves, I think, and that brings us to this list. This is my 10 favorite Walter Hill movies list. I started wanting to make a top 5 list, but I just could not do it, so this turned into something else. I figure it's a cool way to bring some attention to a fantastic, talented, creative force that hasn't gotten half the recognition I feel like he's deserved through the years. Number 10. It's a movie called Crossroads from 1986. It stars Ralph Macchio, Jamie Gertz, Joe Seneca, and Steve Vai. He's in it. Guitar player Steve Vai. It's a blues story that is part Faustian myth and part Devil Went Down to Georgia, which I guess is all kind of the same thing. Very cool movie with a little supernatural angle to it. So, bigger than reality. It's Crossroads. Number 9. It's 1981's Southern Comfort. It stars Powers Booth, Fred Ward, Keith Carradine, Sonny Landham, T.K. Carter, and more people than that. It's a really intense story about a bunch of National Guardsmen on a training exercise in the Louisiana swamplands who managed to really piss off some local Cajuns, and they end up getting hunted. They don't have live ammo. They don't know the swamps, and they are being hunted by some very, very angry and unrelenting people. They do not give up. This one is a cross between Deliverance and a Vietnam War movie. It goes that way on purpose, I think. And it's a great score from Walter Hill regular Ry Cooter, who showed up in Hill movies a lot, and that was Southern Comfort. Next is Trespass, 1992 movie. Robert Zemeckis was one of the writers on this one, by the way. Stars Bill Paxton, Ice-T, Ice Cube, William Sadler, another Ry Cooter score. At its heart, it's, I think, a story about greed and corruption. It's really hard to define. Little bit, maybe, Treasure of the Sierra Madre influence in there. I'll probably get yelled at for saying that, but I think it's in there. Very cool movie. Action, intense. Done the way Walter Hill does it. Okay. Next one is another one I don't have the disc of. These two discs just aren't in the house right now. Southern Comfort in this one, so just going to show pictures again. This is 1984's Streets of Fire, with a cast that has so many familiar names in it, I don't think I could list them all, but what a cast. And it is one surreal movie, man. This takes place in a weird, alternate rock and roll universe that's extremely hard to describe, and surprise, surprise, William Dafoe is a total freak in this movie. I don't think I could really accurately relay this thing, but I very much recommend checking out a trailer or two so you can see for yourself what makes Streets of Fire Streets of Fire. Next up, Charles Bronson in 1975's Hard Times, with Charles Bronson as the star, James Coburn, Strother Martin, Jill Ireland, and more. This one's set in the Depression, features Bronson as a brawler, Coburn as a hustling, fast-talking manager type. In line with something along the same themes as Eastwood's Every Which Way But Loose, but no orangutan, nothing like that. Just 100% bare-knuckle badassery of the highest Bronson Hill order. And keep in mind, If you don't have this and you're interested, there are two versions. They did re-release this full screen only. This one is widescreen and full screen. It's a flipper disc. So do keep that in mind if you decide to go after it. Great movie. Excellent. Next one, Undisputed. Late model Walter Hill from 2002 with Wesley Snipes, Bing Rames, Peter Falk's in it, and a bunch of other recognizable faces I can't remember right now off the top of my head, but it's a prison movie with a boxing angle, plenty of brutality, and I won't say more because if I get talking about this one, I'll just run out my time. I know I will. I do remember that when I saw this in theaters with somebody, opening weekend, I believe it was, there was maybe 10 people there. It's too bad. It's an excellent movie. See, some good word from critics, but it just didn't do it. There are two sequels so far on DVD, direct-to-video. Next one, 48 Hours. Not the double feature, but I'm just talking about 48 Hours. 1982 blockbuster with Nick Nolte and Eddie Murphy. I don't need to say anything about this one, do I? I mean, it's 48 Hours. Even if you haven't seen 48 Hours, you're very familiar with 48 Hours, right? I assume? Everybody knows about this one. It was huge. Got this double feature because of the anamorphic prints. So, there's that. Next one. Extreme Prejudice. 1987 movie with Nick Nolte and Powers Booth. They were friends at one time, and now they each epitomize the black and white, good and evil, opposite sides of the coin, and they both want the same woman. Maria Conchita Alonso. Trouble on the Horizon. Plenty intense, plenty violent, incredible score by Jerry Goldsmith. This is an import I got because the American disc is full screen, and that's a joke because the Laserdisc was widescreen already. So I don't understand why they did that. The print is there. This is anamorphic widescreen. Pick this up. Love it. Awesome. Excellent. Number two, The Driver. It's from 1978, stars Ryan O'Neal, Isabel Adjani, Bruce Dern, and others. This movie's fantastic, so stylish. The characters don't have names, like the driver is known only as the driver, the detective's known only as the detective, etc. This is so sadly underrated. I consider this a must-see movie for just about any movie fan. It's noirish. It's a noirish movie, which you can always feel boiling just beneath the surface. It's got that fire to it in every scene. It's so involving, and it's so immersive. Hill creates a surreal, dark, and gritty, otherworldly feeling perfectly in this movie. I love this movie. Check out The Driver. Very cool. And number one, should be no surprise to people I talk to regularly, but number one is 1979's The Warriors, starring Michael Beck as Swan, the leader of the Warriors, who have been set up to fall. They have to make it from a gang super meeting they attended through all these different territories back home to Coney Island. It's another dreamlike thing created by Hill to suit his take of this tale. Violent confrontation and survival. It's perfection. It's perfect in every way to me. If you haven't seen this one, you owe it to yourself to check it out, but I'm sure most of you have seen this, but yeah, the best. Love this movie so much. The back, just in case anybody wants to see. So that's it, guys. My top 10 Walter Hill movies, and every one of them are rewarding and unique experience, well worth looking into. So take a look, take a ride, never look back. You know, I'd love to see your guys' list, if you have a list, or maybe lists from other underrated directors or underrated actors, effects guys, anything. Good chance to make a list video. Or just leave a list in the comments if you want to. I'd be really interested to see them. So anything you want, if you want. I think it'd be interesting. But that's it for now, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Later.